expressed did not necessarily reflect those of Access for Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
Come one, come all, come Yahweh, come Joshua, come David, confrontation with the soul has come.
In the ways of God, Exodus, feel the vibes of the wrath of God, with the biological art, God one, systematic terror that's forever, King Lord Shredder, a legendary weed better. The dark president, the dark sun resident, will get more reason to impeach your president, and all the puppets in the ever square lay, support 3Ks in America can wait.
They, in the days of the festival, they always read the making of the spirit of Osiris in honor of him at any festival, so this is considered a festival event, so to speak. So, and it's kind of about 15 minutes, 20 minutes long, so I just want to, and I may not read all of it, but just give that a hint, please. Come to thy house, come to thy house, O An, come to thy house, O beautiful bull, the Lord of men and women, the beloved one, the Lord of women. O beautiful face, chief of Ekotet, prince, first of those who are in the other world. Are not all hearts drunk through level feet, O Unnefer triumphant? The hands of men and gods are lifted on high, seeking for thee, even as those of a child are stretched out after his mother. Come thou to them, for their hearts are sad, and make them to appear as being to rejoice. The lands of Horus exalt, the domains of Set are overthrown with fear of thee. Hail Osiris, first of those who are in the other world. I am thy sister Isis. No god hath done for thee what I have done, and no goddess. I made a man-child, though I was a woman, because of my desire to make thy name to live upon the earth. Thy divine essence was in my body. I placed him on the back of the earth, brought him forth. He pleaded thy case. He healed thy suffering. He decreed the destruction of him that had caused it. Set hath fallen before his sword, and the civil things of Set have followed him. That the throne of Keb is to thee, O thou whose heart is O thou whose beloved son. Hail Osiris, this calamity happened to thee in primeval time. There have been made for thee mighty chambers in Tetupasiris, the god Hutepet embalmed thee and made sweet the smell of thee. The god Anpu toiled for thee in the place of purification and performed all the things which he had to perform. I and my sister Nephthys kindled a lamp at the door of the Uric chamber, so that we might snare in a net set like a booth. Anpu came forth from the place of purification and overthrew all your enemies. Past, present, and future, the mourners, male and female, made for thee their lamentations. Horus has overthrown the subtle things and has cast shadows about Set. The gods stand up and utter groans by reason of this great calamity which happened to thee, and they send forth their loud cries unto heaven. Those who dwell on the horizon hear the goddess making lamentation over the motionless one. They see what the accursed one has done, to who he stands at the door of the pure chamber in order to recite his formula which shall give life to thy soul each day. The plowing of the earth has been performed for thee on the day of the fourth month of the season of Ket. Thou comest forth from the Tuat. The sons of Horus are with thee. Horus is before thee with his rope in his hands. The divine father priest and the servants of the god prepare thy two ways in the pure chamber. Thy mouth is opened by the book of the opening of the mouth. The Kerhet priest and the chief of the libation of priests with their books of making the soul to live in your hands recite the formula over thee. The seven priests have opened thy mouth. Sefer and the Hennu boat have triumphed. Thy enemies are overthrown. Hail Osiris, continuity. O come to us. O come to thy sister. O Unnefer triumphant. Hail Osiris, continuity. The gods and the goddesses with their heads and their knees await thy coming to them. Men with outcry and shouting call out, O thou who art invisible, come to us. O soul, perfect to all eternity. Thy members are in a state of well-being. Thy sufferings are relieved. Every evil thing in thee is done away. Thy limbs are rejoined. Thou art protected. Thou hast no defect. Thy limbs are rejoined, and not a member of thine is wanting. Now we're going into the reading of the literal making of his spirit, the fifth honor of heaven. Hail Osiris, Kintiamenti, O form, thou hast thy heart. It has been re-dipped in the primeval waters, and it beats and flows oxygen and life throughout your veins. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, you have your phallus. It has been re-dipped in the primeval waters that you mayest populate. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thou hast thy head, O God of the lifted hand. Thy crown and thy hair are made of genuine lapis lazuli. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thou hast thy two eyes, thou seest with them. The Maati goddess is left to protect thee. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thou hast thine ears, wherewith thou shalt hear prayers for millions of years, in all time, distance, and space. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thou hast thy nose, thy nostrils snuff the breezes. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thou hast thy mouth, thou speakest therewith. Horus has pressed forth in thy mouth. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy jawbones are on thee firmly fixed. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy beard is made of crystal which emitteth rays of light. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy lips are flint and thy teeth are turquoises. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy tongue is the pilot of the two lands. It looketh up all thine enemies, past, present, and future, in all forms of time, space, distance. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy body is of natron, it perisheth not. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy neck beareth ornaments and amulets which reach to thy throat. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy hands are firm on the staff, which is stable in thy abode. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy sinews and thy vertebrae and joints are established firmly. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy belly, thy secret place, hideth that which is in it. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thy two shoulders are established firmly on thy back. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thou hast thy members and thy genitals that thou mayest populate. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thou hast thy backbone. It's just one more paragraph. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, thou hast thy backbone and thy buttocks that thou sittest upon thy throne every day. Hail Osiris, last sentence. Hail Osiris, Kintiamintio form, the soles of thy feet are on the earth, the water flood appears with them. O Osiris, Kintiamintio, Isis and Nephthys say it. I'm Sister Madeline Carroll. Greetings.
What does that tell you yourself? That you don't know enough about your own movement and about certain progresses you have not made and why it has taken place. Are you clear? Jawali came here not only to redeem the Moorish Americans and to restore the nation, but to make you capable of taking your places amongst the affairs of men. I know you all are familiar with that. The fundamentals of your operations as a national should be well-grounded. It should have been well-grounded 60 years ago. So we're going to be dealing with some different subject matters. If you got a paper and pencil, write on. You got a piece of toilet paper, write on that. Familiar with that. The fundamentals of your operations as a national should be well-grounded. It should have been well-grounded 60 years ago. So we're going to be dealing with some different subject matters. If you got a paper and pencil, write on. You got a piece of toilet paper, write on that. Because I'm going to give you some keys and you're going to have to do some research. So some things I'll tell you, you may be familiar with, you may not be. And I know a lot of you are scholars and some of you are addicts. Addicts would already know. But also is information you should have been told anyway. But because of what they call the great sellout, certain information has not been given out. So some information I'll be giving out will be some of the information that's been held back from you. Are you clear? Now, I want to make a statement, and we want to analyze that statement. Prophet Noble Jawali said, some of the Sheikhs have followers. He said, some of the Grand Sheikhs have followers. Say, some of the governors have followers. But I, your prophet, have no followers. Do you understand that statement? If you don't, I'm going to read the Book of East to you. That was supposed to be, who got a Holy Quran? How many got a Service 7 of the Quran? How many of you got the Book of East, the second part? How many of you got the Book of the East, the second part? Indicator of the sellout. Now, have no followers. Do you understand that statement? If you don't, I'm going to read the Book of the East to you. That was supposed to be, who got a Holy Quran? How many got the Service 7 of the Quran? How many of you got the Book of the East, the second part? How many of you got the Book of the East, the second part? Indicator of the sellout. Now you understand what the sellout is? Huh? This is the Book of the East. Now I start putting it out because I recognize a lot of people who claim to be Grand Sheikh protecting the movement have been more interested in power play rather than raising the people. Meanwhile, the Europeans have been abusing our people when they should have been rescued decades ago. This is the Book of the East, second part of the Holy Quran. The Book of the East, now that you understand and you've been given the lessons of Jesus, then they take you to the higher plane. And now you're told the truth. His name is Yahshua. Are we clear? So it goes from Jesus, that's why in your questionnaire it says, what does the name Jesus mean? It says, Jesus means justice. Right? Now, I'm going to give you, for those of you who are scholars, this is another added degree. Like, say, if tonight you were having a Bible study, right? If I was presenting that to you, I would ask you, everybody got your literature, right? And then I'd ask you, do you have your septuagint? How many of you recognize that? Good, good, good. Septuagint, what does it mean? And what is it?
It's basically our writing.
Yes, it is. Yeah. Septuagint is the first transliteration from the Book of the Dead and from the ancient Ukipta script. Also from the Mauryan, the Nanda, and the Gupta dynasties in what you call today India, which is Hindustan. Do you understand? Which is Moorish background. This information, when the prophet gave you the Quran, he says, this information has been held back from you by what? The Muslims of India, Palestine, etc. You see? And Egypt. And he tailored it just for you. Why? Because he found us under Roman misconceptions. Thus, Arab degrees are for those who have developed and are prepared to go back to the state of mind of their ancient mothers and fathers and deal with the truth as it is, unfettered, uncolored. You understand what I'm saying? Septuagint is Latin, Moorish Latin. It actually means 70, the 70. It was actually 72 scholars that did the major transliterations out of Ibri, because it's not Hebrew, it's Ibri. We say Hebrew, but it's Hebrew, right? And out of the Greek. And what is Greek is actually Ekupta, or what you call Egypt. It ain't no Greek culture. That's Egypt. Do you understand? They're just taking credit because they're stealing your legacy. You don't knock them, but understand that, when they say Greek, they're really saying Egypt. Because the culture that is the foundation of the philosophies for the Western Hemisphere that they say come from Greece is Egypt. You understand? Egypt, capital dominion of what? A mess. Are we clear? Now I'm going to read a chapter, one of my favorite chapters from the Book of the East. That's the mysteries of the secret of the silent brotherhood of the East. That's the other half of the Quran that anybody who's Moorish American, you got a Holy Quran, this is your second part. All right? And I only brought a few with me, a couple of them anyway, because I want to travel light. Plus, when I'm traveling, they like to lose my stuff. You know what I mean? They'd like to lose me. Anyhow, but I'm going to read you chapter 7, and I'm sure that you'll appreciate why some people who claim to be grand sheikhs don't want you to have this literature. But they say they love the prophet. They say they love you. They say they love the Moorish movement. Well, I don't think history is going to register that as fact, because we should not be so far behind, and we should not be suffering the issues that we're suffering, including the profile and all the other crap that's been going on, without them speaking up. Because they were put in place to make law, but they've been lying to the people, telling the people that Jarali didn't teach law. The prophet told them, if you don't think that the program I have for the redemption of my people and the citizens is right, you go to those who know law. And then the grand sheikhs turn around and tell people that Jarali didn't teach law. He's also a professor of juror, the lawman. Anyways, chapter 8. I'm going to go past 7, but I'm going to read chapter 8. And then we're going to make some explanations. Take notes. The council of the seven of the world. In every age since time began, but seven sages lived. At first of every age, these sages meet to note the course of nations, people, tribes, and tongues. To know how far toward justice and love the race has gone. To formulate the code of law, religious postulates, and plans of rule best suited to the coming age. An age had passed, and lo, another age had come, and the sages must convene. Now, Alexandria was the center of the world's best thought, and here in Philo's home the sages met. From China came Menstet, from India Vidyapati came, from Persia Caspar came, and from Assyria Ashpina came, and from Greece Apollo came. Methano was the Egyptian sage, and Philo was the chief of Ivory thought. The time was due. The council met and sat in silence, 7 days. And then Mitch arose and said, the wheel of time has turned once more, and the race is on a higher plane of thought. The garments that our fathers wore have given out. The cherubim have woven a celestial cloth and have placed it in our hands, and we must make for men new garments. The sons of men are looking up for greater light. No longer do they care for gods hewn out of wood. They seek for Allah, not made with hands. They see the beams of coming days and yet comprehend them not. The time is right, and we must fashion well these garments for the race. And let us make for men new garments of justice, mercy, and love, that they may hide their nakedness when shines the light of coming days. And Vidyapati said, our priests have all gone mad. They saw a demon in the wilds and at him cast their lamps, and they are broken up, and not a gleam of light has any priest for men. The night is dark, the heart of India calls for light. The priesthood cannot be reformed. It is already dead. Its greatest needs are graves and funeral chants. The new age calls for liberty, the kind that makes each man a priest, enables him to go alone and lay his offerings on the shrine of Allah. And Caspar said, in Persia, people walk in fear. They do the good for fear to do the wrong. The devil is the greatest power in our land, and though a myth, he dandles on his knees both youth and age. Our land is dark, and evil prospers in the dark. Fear rides on every passing breeze and lurks in every form of life. The fear of evil is a myth. It is an illusion and a snare, but it will live until some mighty power shall come and raise the ethers to the plane of light. And when this shall come to pass, the Magian land will glory in the light, and the soul of Persia calls for light. Nogdrali is a dragon slayer. That's why the Grand Sheiks ain't going to let y'all see this book, because they part of the priesthood. That's why they sold the movement out. They're trying to preserve the priesthood instead of carrying out the mission. Are we clear? Don't get angry, get wise. You understand? This is the reason why they criticize anybody that produces literature according to what the prophet said. The prophet said, in order to change these people, you, and that's them sheiks, grand sheiks, adepts, are charged to change their literatures. Now I'm going to read also a snippet. Let's see, find something over here. I know I got something right here somewhere. Excuse me for a minute, but I just want to get you all grounded before we give you some other information, because we want to be on point. Relative to the temples. And he also said, the half has not been told. If I told you everything, you'd go back to sleep. That's to let you know everything was not immediately given to you, but you would have to study in order to recognize some of the keys that he brought you. But let's talk about, from the prophet's own words, what he says about the newspaper, and you take this in consideration with those who've been stealing people's finances, claiming to love the prophet. All right? And then trying to tell you what to do and what not to do. No drawing. The greatest weapon in the hands of our group today in America is our press. That was his reference to the newspapers that he set up. He set up industry. He set up Sister Pearl, his wife, set up a woman's auxiliary, taught women business, housekeeping, science, culture, etc. Not emotionalism. Real culture. Young Businessmen's League to teach young brothers business, how to do business, how to structure business, how to administer business. A press, two newspapers. How many of you knew that the Morris Movement at one time had one of the largest fishing industries on the East Coast? Right in Camden, New Jersey, between Broadway, 7th Street, down to 3rd Street, almost all those buildings belong to Moores. They had a canning factory. How many of you know the science, Moore Science Center had a canning factory? Not enough hands. I'm just telling you these things so you can recognize how much has been held back from you, from these people who keep on trying to tell you not to be active because you ain't under their tutelage when they sold this movement out. And they're judging you because you're active and not passive. And they're angry because you're communicating and standing for your birthright, which they have not done. While the Europeans have been attacking you and other people have been attacking you. Yet that's their position. Let me finish this because I'm getting a little ticked with this. The truth will never be told about a disadvantaged minority by the general press of any country, whether that minority be racial, political, or religious. Unless we express ourselves through papers of our own, the truth about us will not be told. Our papers are our only hope of shoveling ourselves out from under the avalanche of lies that are annually let loose upon us. And a strong and free press is the best possible safeguard of the liberties in general, promotion and defense of the interest of a strong, free people. Signed, Nobel Drawley. How come they don't say that when they open up the meetings all the time? But they're making judgments of active Moors out here that's doing the work that they should have done 50 years ago. Wow. Trying to pull a rank on somebody. Well, we have an accent. Y'all heard the term, y'all heard Duali say sometimes, he says, some of my best followers are in the church. You ever heard that? What did he mean? Do you know what he meant? Anybody that know the esoteric knowledge, tell me what he meant. Now I'm going to give you a lesson. Hold this. Every preacher knows this. Every rabbi knows this. Every grand sheik knows this. Every PhD knows this. Every shakun knows this. What I'm getting ready to show you. Isn't it interesting that the followers and believers are never told this, what I'm getting ready to tell you? Now, draw me some of my best followers in the church, right? You look at some of them old churches, right? So we're going to do the building here to give you some concepts, and then we're going to clean it up and make sure you know something that the preacher ain't going to tell you. You're going to get mad because you ain't supposed to know this because he paid for these degrees and took an oath of Rome not to reveal secrets, but it's yours, it's your birthright. We're going to need another marker, but I'm going to try to work with this. Now, how many of you go to old graveyards and see the old churches and you see the cross and you see the circle around the cross? How many? Raise your hand, because I need you to know that you're all familiar with what you saw. All right? And you look at the buildings, right? And you say that's the church, right? It is and it isn't. It's that symbol that's the church. How many of you knew that? In other words, you need to be waking up. You need, in other words, in order, you know how the Nazarene saying, know you the truth and the truth will set you free? Huh? Did you notice that? Them same people who keep talking about religion, always talking about what the devil did, but if people pay attention to the history, it's people who claim to be religionists that always murder the prophets. They say, look, the devil did that. And people start looking for this mystical devil to go beat his butt and raise money to beat his butt. And it's really people who claim to be organized religionists that really plot the death of the prophets. Because they're not really teaching religion, they're teaching dogma. And they keep the religion for their personal selves. That's their source of power. Do you understand? So I'm going to show you the relationship to wake you up, to remove the mystery. Because you will never be free until you learn the mysteries. And it's only mysteries because it's been held back from you, not because it's not capable for you to know. You notice that all these people always tell you? I was talking to Jesus this morning. Let me get myself together. And he's broke. You got $5. You know, the roof we fixed last year, this week, and again, we got to raise $50,000 for the roof. Wait a minute, let me call Jesus and give him his hand. But he's really going to the Bahamas with Susie. And they've been getting away with this forever. Any God that's broke, you don't need him, he needs you. A child understands that the supreme powers of the universe does not submit to what you call money, which is an instrument of man for his personal, private, material interchange. Got nothing to do with divine. But people who have the mentality of children will fall for it and give these demons the house that their mother gave them that should went to the children, and they're out here poor. And these demons walk around with $3,000 suits and everything, talking about Allah said so and Jesus said so. Going to the Bahamas with Susie. And they've been getting away with this forever. Any God that's broke, you don't need him, he needs you. A child understands that the supreme powers of the universe does not submit to what you call money, which is an instrument of man for his personal, private, material interchange. Got nothing to do with divine. But people who have the mentality of children will fall for it and give these demons the house that their mother gave them that should went to the children, and they're out here poor. And these demons walk around with $3,000 suits and everything, talking about Allah said so and Jesus said so. They're liars and they're robbers. Because they have knowledge that they haven't given to you, and every one of the major religions can be traced back to cosmology. Every last one of them. Every last one of them. Because that's the truth of religion. That's why they maintain secret societies for their rulers, in order for them to have the power and give you dogma and lie and say they're giving you religion. Religion is the study of the stars. Anybody got an etymology dictionary? Do they teach orthology in school to the children?
No.
Well, do the research. Orthology, etymology, is the truth, the mother of the word, the heart of the word, its true meaning, denotation versus connotation. Religion is a study of the stars. This is why you have the symbol of the cross that represents the holy cross of what you call the mundane cross of the earth mastery. If you look in physics, they'll have that same symbol with that circle and that cross in it. You look amongst the different tribes here, the dream catcher is that same circle and the cross in it. It means absolutely the same thing. You see the swastika, that is where you get the name Supreme Being. How many did you know that? They have you thinking it's a negative, don't they? It's one of the most ancient religious symbols on the planet. It is the four gates of the universe. And these are things that they know that they won't teach you. I'm clear. Got another marker, brother? Good. Now, give you another key. Drawley said, man, know thyself, and thy father God Allah, right? Right? Why is that? Know thyself and thy father God Allah. If you don't know yourself, you can't talk about that which you don't see. If you don't love your brothers and sisters that you see every day, don't talk about those gods that you don't see. You're in violation of divine law as soon as that comes out your mouth or comes out your attitude. Know that. They have you thinking it's a negative, don't they? It's one of the most ancient religious symbols on the planet. It is the four gates of the universe. And these are things that they know that they won't teach you. I'm clear. Got another marker, brother? Good. Now, give you another key. Drawley said, man, know thyself, and thy father God Allah, right? Right? Why is that? Know thyself and thy father God Allah. If you don't know yourself, you can't talk about that which you don't see. If you don't love your brothers and sisters that you see every day, don't talk about those gods that you don't see. You're in violation of divine law as soon as that comes out your mouth or comes out your attitude. Now, I'm going to give you another lesson. Give me a napkin or something. I got some pieces here. I'm going to show you what is called relativity, right? In symbolism. This is another reason when they're teaching so-called religion, they keep symbolism amongst the priesthood, but they don't teach it to the followers. Why don't teach you the followers? Because the followers pay the bills. Are you clear? Drew Ali came to free you from that. Are we clear? I'm just telling you the truth. Don't get mad because you ain't used to hearing it, but I'm just telling you what it is. Do you understand? So don't take it personal. He didn't come here to hurt anybody. He came to free you from the corruption of the dead priesthood that's been preserving itself and hiding the truth from you. And while they and the state have been partners in secret societies, raping you and destroying your families and blaming it on Jesus, knowing that they're lying. Knowing that they're lying, not guessing. Knowing that they're lying. That's why when anybody brings you the truth, they get mad at them and they target them. Because it exposes them to criminals that they absolutely are. Because they know the truth while they won't tell you the truth. They themselves won't enter in and they hinder you from getting it.
Right.
Another truth. In all secret societies, whether it's the Jesuits, DAR, Girls of American Revolution, Kyklos, what you call Ku Klux Klan, Union Guard, White Camellia, Eastern Star, Master Masons, etc., all of them in secret wear this fez. Do you know why? You know why? Because that's the root of your servitude. They took it from you and gave you dogma. In other words, they took your science, ruled the world, gave you dogma, called the religion and it's counterfeit, and you are enslaved. You start following after the idol gods of Europe that you knew nothing of, and you just think this is some club thing. Except in the secret society, they call Corona Sol, which means the crown of the sun. There's a science that's on top, and we'll deal with that later. But right now, I'm going to give you something to work with. When you see this, how many of you deal with mathematics, geometry, physics, chemistry? That's the earth glyph, isn't it? That's the glyph of the earth, isn't it? Now, in metaphysical science, In philosophy, it would be called the mundane cross, which means the earth cross, right? When you get in your higher degrees, it would be called the master's seal. All right? Now, the master's seal, then you see your threes in the corners. This is called the osis of the gnosis, or more science. Are we clear? Now, how many of you can just loosely give me a demonstration of your knowledge of this? Because I know you all had this. At least somebody told you you had it. Because they gave it to you like this. You know that means the same thing. Here's your four gates. What makes this seven? It is the science of the four threes. You got three in the north. And here you go, your high priest. Say, I rule the earth. I master the earth. North gate, south gate, east gate, west gate, I'm the ruler, the vicar of the law of the universe. That's why the high priests call themselves vicars, because they murdered, the Nazarene murdered all the prophets and act as a substitute, as God on earth, and you worship them. That's the rule of Constantine, the Roman ruler, and Pope Sylvester, who introduced tithing, which is a Roman tax, and said that Jesus said it. But people who study know that. People who don't read don't know that. Are we clear? And you need to know that. If you're ever going to be free, you need to know the truth. It's uncomfortable, because it rocks the boat, but it is absolutely true and researchable. Are we clear? Now, these four corners of the earth, of that mundane cross, with the three threes on it, is called the three times the four, which is your circle of the seven. You see? It's the science. Let me give you another ritual. I'm giving the same thing to you in ritual. You know how Muslims make the Hajj? Right? And they go to the Kaaba, and the Kaaba is a cube, and they make rotations seven times counterclockwise around the cube, around the square. That's circle seven, but it's only ritual. But if you give them circle seven, the science, they'll reject it because they haven't been given the philosophy. See how they create division? Do you understand? And they have people doing things ritualistically, and don't even know if you look in the Bible, right? Thank you. Book of Revelation. It says, I heard one who speak with a voice of many waters, and he was standing among seven golden candlesticks. Right? That seven golden candlesticks is still that seven there. How many of you read Quran, Uwasti, the Vedas, the Torah, Pentateuch, Hexateuch, the Bible, Septuagint? And see the name Elohim. What does Elam mean? Say it. Say it so we can hear you. Can you stand up? The seven eyes of Allah, right? And in the church they'll tell him it's God, right? Right? In the Bible they'll tell you Elohim is God, right? How many people know that there's seven golden candlesticks and that circle seven and this science all relate to the same powers? Now the key is, do you know how to exercise those powers? Take you to another degree. Write this down. It's very important. How many people know what God means? Wait, stand up. I want you to stand up because you raise your hand. Stand up and stand still using the camera. Because I want you to come back to this lesson because you're going to give yourself a lesson. Then you stand up, look at that camera, and tell what it is. Now notice that most of the people didn't stand up or raise their hand, which means they're either not sure or something's up. So go ahead.
Government ordinance departments.
Yes, it does. On a political realm, it does. Yes. What's it mean? Camera.
Transit department.
Oh! So now somebody's been studying.
That's right. Good job. Give me a
second, bro. You earned that job. What does God mean?
It's a transitive verb.
What is a transitive verb?
Means to invoke, pour out.
And pour out, and call upon.
Call.
Yes. Now, sis, when you gave libation, that's where it comes from. God is a German word. How old is it on the planet called Earth? Exactly. Is it ancient? It is not. Where does it derive from? Quran. What is it? And what does it mean? It's a verb transitive, and it means to call upon. To invoke. And to pour out. What give high priests their power? Why do rabbis and ministers have all the power and the people always paying the bills? Because they won't tell you the truth. How do they disconnect you from the creative forces? By misclassifying it. Plugging it into an improper matrix. And they just plugged you into an improper matrix. Now they got control of your life. And look innocent, don't they? Like they love you, like you got some special relationship with Jesus, God, and Allah, and Muhammad. And they're raping you. When you do libation, sis, when you speak of libation, the ritual of libation is called godding. It's a doing, not a being. The creator, the collective universal forces of the universe, which are called Alim, Allah, Tetragrammaton, Dahuri, Tom, Hermes Trismegistus, they're different names applied to the same forces and power. How many of you know that Tetragrammaton is the proper name of God? And how many of your preachers ever told you that? Because they get it to get their degrees. How come they didn't tell you? They get it to get their PhDs. How come they didn't tell you? Brother, come up for us for a second. Here's an ordinary dictionary. We were planning to bring some good stuff, but pressure and time. I want you to look up Tetragrammaton. Tetragrammaton. It's a process, actually. Are we clear? You know, like when other people come from other countries and other people who happen to be ruling in your land, and they like to make fun of our people, talk about, you ain't got to worry about them. You just say to them, Allah, Jesus, or Muhammad, and they'll give you their baby's milk money. Because they don't deal with facts, they only deal with beliefs. They have total disdain and disregard of you. But yet, it is the culture of your forefathers and foremothers to have a library in the house just like you got a kitchen. If you didn't have a library, you were out of order. not until you were conquered by the Romans and they began to do their massive book burnings around the world that you lost your culture. Tetragrammaton. Here you go. Now y'all write this down. Y'all got this? Understand? Now, this is, make sure that you understand. How many of the Oxford dictionaries? Oxford, good. Unabridged dictionary. We're in trouble. We got some work to do, y'all. Go look up Tetragrammaton. And I'm gonna spell it for you. Y'all got this? Another key for y'all to look at, you ever see them holding pictures, or they do old pictures of saints and the Nazarene, Yeshua? Did y'all ever notice that his head was set right in the center of this? And the bottom of the south gate was at the medulla of the brain? How many people paid attention to the gates? It's because that's a symbol of the logos. You see? It's also called the nimbus. These things is important for you to know because it's the foundation of civilization on the planet. On the planet. Irregardless of nation. Just because they don't tell you, don't think they don't know. Are we clear? Do you see Tetragrammaton? All right, now, I want you to read it. Tetragrammaton.
The four consonants of the ancient Hebrew name of God, for God.
All right, now, what are the four consonants? Y, H, V. And the four consonants is what they call the ineffable word, or unpronounceable, and they say Yahweh, or what Yahweh, or the corruption, Jehovah, or Allah, Alain. Are you understand? Therefore, if anybody's been taught religion and they don't know that, whoever's been teaching you haven't been teaching you religion. Because they haven't been giving you the truth. They've been giving you some kind of club to control you and get you to pay their bills. Do you understand? All scholars must know that to get their degrees to be teaching religion. How come the people aren't familiar with that? I'm only pointing that out to you to show you, without doubt, you've been played. I'm not trying to convince you or try to convince you of anything. I'm not trying to change your belief of anything. Giving you some basic truth that I know that you need, because I know certain people that got these on who know Raleigh put in place to take this to the four corners of the earth, to all nations, have sold out to J. Edgar Hoover and ain't been teaching it. And you've been catching it, as we all have, for not enforcing the law. When they get their degrees, this is one of the rituals they do. They'll put them in front of a tree stump or an altar with three lights, three candle lights. Symbolic, or either three candles, standing for the Trinity, or what you call Triune Allah, or three lights. Are we clear? I want you to understand this, that true religion does not promote belief systems. How many people knew that? True religion does not promote belief systems. True religion finds you in belief and raises you up to higher planes. Why? Beliefs are for children.
Beliefs first for children.
Yes, exactly. I'll give you a key. Keep in mind, while I give you the symbolism, physics. Right? Physics and science. So symbolically, we'll have three candles. And of course, the little flame represents light. Just like you see in the book of Revelation, when they talk about the Nazarene standing amongst seven golden candlesticks, he says, I heard one speak with a voice of many waters, and he was standing amongst seven golden candlesticks, but Adam, in whose right hand he had seven stars. Now, the seven golden candlesticks are symbolic. The stars are the real. Which one is one? One is symbolic. One is the real science. Meaning, you can speculate or you can operate. What you want to do, whosoever will, let them come. The first light is belief. And the root word is lie. Second light is faith. And that's what man believes to be true without proof. Go look it up in the dictionary. No foundations whatsoever. Now, this is what the masses are given. Like, say, for instance, most people that have these so-called religious houses, they bring you in and they give you those too. How many of you didn't know there's five more parts to this? I'm glad you do. I'll give you the other five parts. The earth is the third rock from the sun, is it? And in the physical form, you see in what they call 3 degrees, three dimensions, right? And then the most important symbol, when they give you mathematics or geometry of the operations of the planet Earth, or they deal you with the quark, going beyond the atom structure in science, you get a triangle, which is symbolized by the symbol of civilization on the planet called Earth, and actually on a couple of other planets in this particular solar system. It's called the Great Seal Pyramid. The largest base of the largest pyramid on the planet Earth is in Mexico City. How many of you knew that? Glad you did, but we need to make sure everybody gets up on it, because understand, the rest of the world knows this. This is what they have on you. They're not prejudiced. They have knowledge of you while you have no knowledge of yourself. Therefore, all you can do is work for them and serve them. Particularly because most of you using their name, go around buying and selling with the mark and a number of that Roman name, that get mad at the Roman because he's charging you and accusing him of racism. And there's only one race on the planet, it's called the human race. Even the words being misused. Because without the honor of your mothers and your fathers, your days will be shortened on this planet. I guarantee that. If you're talking about an inheritance, corporal or incorporeal, and you're transacting business in another man's name, chalk it up. Because human rights don't apply to you. However, chattel property warrantship under the 14th Amendment does, as a corporate entity, construct what they call something that is colored, which means artificial, distinguished from that which is real. That's law. Not opinion, law. We're clear. So a lot of times when our people accuse the Europeans of being racist, that's because the criminal gave you the argument. Because it's a false argument. He's stealing your birthright. He's living off your virtues. Are we clear? Now let me give you the other five. What makes the difference between all right, up here saying, I'm doing all this and we, hallelujah to you, and everything else, right? Preacher, rabbi, imam, grand chief, and all the rest of the crew. What makes them worthy of the title and you don't have it? What do you think makes them have that title? This is what makes them have that title. Because they know about the third degree of the Trinity, the Triune Allah, and that is fruition. How many people, I know most of y'all know about belief and faith, how many of y'all know about fruition? How many people told you about that? Of course, those who are addicts, or those who've been properly taught know that, but look how true it is, when even the children should know. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? Children should know that.